I pressed the live button, so any time now it's going to say you're live, and I'll be able to give my you're live.
Maybe I think it happens before it, the button comes but up.
There it is. See, it just came up. Okay. Live from Houston, Texas, is the Ginger Crumb Monday Show with your host Ginger Cook.
Oh, hi, John.
Hey, Ginger. Doesn't that sound like Wilbur?
Hi, everybody. Wilbur. It's just Wilbur, huh?
Wilbur.
Oh, yeah. Remember that? The horse that could talk?
The horse that could talk. Love the horse that could talk.
That used to be my... God, I love that show. I was a kid. Love that
great.
Show.
Hey, the so what are we going to do tonight?
Oh, gosh. John, we've got a really exciting... you guys want to welcome everybody. We're going to be painting. I'll just hold it up here. We're going to be painting. This is a stormy sea, all right? The stormy sea. I think it was called... We titled this A Dark Stormy Night, after a story that they used to tell at camp when I was a kid. We'll tell you that what that is. We've talked about that. Everybody likes these reminiscent things. Reminiscent, don't you think so?
Reminiscing. That word. Reminiscent things.
Yeah, just I had a neighbor that did that one time. Her name was June, and she lived next door to us, and Cinnamon was about 5 at the time. And June had these great stories of old Hollywood, you know, old, because she was, her son was married to, not her son, was married to, I don't know, the family connection was to some big movie star, okay? And they all used to work for this movie star back when she was in her 20s, and this lady was in her 60s when I knew her. And so I remember Cinnamon went over to her house one day and says, June, would you tell me some more stories? I love how you rave on, so. So
it's always great.
It's always great. That's out of the mouth of kids. So we're going to rave on a little bit tonight. We're going to talk about how to do this. I'm going to paint it and show you. We'll leave this video up. If you're new to the channel and you just stumbled through YouTube and saw a sign, someone's live, and what are we doing? We're doing acrylic painting. That's what we do here. We chat a little bit. Everybody, if you have a question about acrylic painting or something like that, be sure to put it in capital letters. We don't always see it. If it's really important that you want to know it, if it's really a matter, write me ahead of time, and then I'll make sure, then send me a reminder the day of the show saying, hey, don't forget, you promised to answer my question.
That would be helpful.
Yeah, the day of the show, send me a reminder. Ginger, remember I have a question. You said you'd answer it on the show. That'd be good, right? Then I'll remember I'm supposed to do that. I should have a folder for that in my email. Answered questions.
Oh, that'd be too organized.
I know. Well, nobody's that organized. Listen, we don't fold socks here.
Whoa. There happens to be some sock folders in the family here. Samuel.
Oh, use a wealth. But I'm saying if you want me to do it, you know what I mean? If I'm not folding the socks, chances are I'm not putting it in some folder either, you know? Chances are. Good intentions, though, right?
Always.
Let's just scoot down to our picture here.
Scoot down. I love it the way you
do. Do you like that? Don't you love this? It's kind of a dark stormy sea. And there are very few colors in this. There's burnt umber, ultramarine blue, cad red medium, yellow oxide, and then transparent white or mixing white. And titanium white. Those are the colors.
And you have a slot for cad red, but you don't have it out yet.
We don't need it for forever. And so yeah. I hate to put it out and just have it dry out here on the set. You know, it makes sense. True.
So would you classify this as a limited palette?
Yeah, that's a good example of a limited palette. And you know, they used to do that in the good old days when they had to mix their paint by themselves. You know what I'm saying? There was a time, like, you know, in the 1500s and stuff like that. Well, really, curl up into the 1800s when everybody had to mix their own paint. And sometimes artists couldn't afford their own paint. I want to just show you this. This is from an old painting that sort of inspired this picture, see? From, you know, way back in the 1500s. Okay.
And that's a very limited palette.
And so that was the genesis of this picture.
I love when you say that.
Genesis of this. Well, every idea had to come from somewhere.
So it's a genesis.
And so that was the genesis of this picture. Now right. I've got a little 8x10 canvas, and what I got to do is sand it because it's very rough. And someone will always ask, and it's all right.
I was going to ask.
This question.
Hey, why are you sanding that? I don't get that.
I know.
It's already pre-gessoed. Is it ready to go?
It's like Groundhog Day for you, isn't it?
It seems like every Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday is the same thing.
You ask me the same questions. It must be Groundhog Day. All right, so we're going to say it better. So you'll remember for next week.
Oh, wait a minute, Ginger. Your hair looks great.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much.
And that wasn't from me. That was from Maria.
Oh, thank you very much. Oh,
even though
you.
I told you earlier, but I don't count.
Well, no, you count.
No.
You count, but it's nice to have confirmation, you know. All right, now see, this canvas is all rough, and we're going to sand it. I'm going to sand it. because otherwise your brushes wear out really fast. And if you spend any money on brushes, you really don't want them to wear out. And also you use less paint. So all it's a sandpaper, light sandpaper. What's the number on that, John?
That would be 220.
You know, or something like that. Whatever you got.
Extra
you know?
Fine.
Extra fine.
It's supposed to be extra fine. We happen to be using something a little heavier because that's all we have.
Well, you know,
one of these times we should go by the store and pick some up.
I know, but it's like Home Depot. It's just like you can't go into Home Depot for one five. You know, I don't want to stand in line for 10 hours for 1 5-cent piece of sandpaper. You know what I'm saying?
5 cent. And when was the last time you bought sandpaper?
About 1947.
That's what I'm thinking. 5 cent sandpaper.
There's no such thing as 5 cent sandpaper?
I don't think so.
Really?
I don't think so.
Really?
Really.
I'm shocked. I'm truly shocked.
I don't understand it either.
You know, I remember when I used to think about this is, gosh, I hate, do you know how to tell, you know how you can tell when someone's getting old? It's not how many facelifts they've had and that kind of, that starts to show. You can tell because their conversation starts with, I remember when. that usually doesn't start till you're after about 45, and then you start hearing it. By the time people are in their 50s, there's a, I remember that when this happened. And then, boy, the older you get, the more you remember how stuff was better and cheaper. Isn't that true? All right, so.
Hey, wait, here's a question. This is a question from Cheryl. I thought the reason we buy gesso is for extra tooth, so why sand it?
No, that's not the reason you buy gesso. Good Lord, that's not the reason you buy gesso.
Oh.
No, that is the next.
I couldn't pass that one up.
Big X, X, King's X, King's X. Did you ever say that, King's X?
King's X.
King's X, that's just not so.
No, I've never heard that one.
Never heard that one. Who's heard King's X? That's what we used to say when you were really wrong. King's X.
King's X. Okay, anyways, what's the purpose of the gesso?
Gesso, look, this is what you're painting on, fabric. And it would just soak
bleed
right
through.
The gesso is your layer between the fabric and
your paint.
And it's got, you got to have it. You know, 100, you know, back in the time of that other painting I showed you was, they used to use rabbit skin glue, and that's nasty stuff. And you put it in powder and kind of powder form. I don't know if they had to kill the rabbit too. I mean, who knows? But it'd be fun to look that up. But anyway, rabbit skin glue, and it smelled nasty and stunk up the whole house. And that's how oil painters 100 years ago, 200 years ago, protected their linen and fabric canvases.
Linen.
Because otherwise the canvas, and guess what? Your canvas would rot.
Ooh.
With oil paint, your canvas would actually start rotting if you didn't put gesso on it. Had nothing to do with tooth. Boy, interesting.
Well, we learned something today. We can all go home now. Show's over. Thanks for coming, folks. We answered the question and we're good to go.
Yeah, I mean, telling you what. All right, so we got this canvas. We've sanded it, okay. Now, we've got our ruby satin silver brush.
What number is that?
This is a number 12. I don't even have to look anymore, right? It's a bright brush, and it doesn't mean it's smart, but they are smart brushes. Hey, speaking of brushes, I'm going to give a shout-out to my daughter, Cinnamon. She is in Utah. This is real important. She landed the deal, you guys. I mean, I'm telling you what. She landed the deal with Silver Brush Company, the people that make my brushes. Well, they're not just mine. I mean, these are the ones I've been using for 25 years, okay? But Cinnamon, you know, landed the deal with the owner of that company. She's in Utah at big art
convention
where they feature art supplies, and vendors come up to her and talk to her. And you know this, you want to be shocked, you want to know why stuff isn't in your art store, let me tell you, because she was telling me that most of those people there that are the ones that are buying the stuff for the art supply stores have never heard of YouTube.
What?
Yeah, now how is it, how could somebody, I mean, I've known about
how
YouTube.
How could you say that in public? I mean, really say that?
I mean, how stupid does that make you, really? I mean, uninformed. I mean, you're in the business of selling product and you don't know, you don't understand that there's all these artists. And she told me that she was explaining, there's one artist that does, you know, does these fancy pen drawings. And apparently he had 2 million viewers on that, you know, on one lesson he did with that pen. You don't suppose some of those 2 million people went out and bought that pen? You don't think that pen distributor ought to be talking to that guy? I think so, you know, just saying. I mean, this is how, I mean, I go on YouTube, this is how we all get informed. I would thank Lori, the one that had those great tennis shoes. She sent me that picture of those artist tennis shoes. I bought those right away, right?
Yeah. Jumped on that deal.
I'm going to have a show. We're going to paint this. I'm going to tell you. I'm going to have a thing.
Yeah, just hang in there, folks. We will get the paint out shortly.
All right. Sorry, I got to digress.
Before you get too far into it, I mean, you can do your mixing. The question is, who painted the reference painting that you used as an idea?
I have no idea.
Just found it on YouTube.
I give up. Who painted? I give up. Who painted it? I just found it, and I didn't even bother to write down who did it.
Because you didn't. All you took was just the idea.
So long ago.
I'm going to change it so much, anyways.
Yeah. So I didn't bother to round. I guess I could find it. It would take me a while to find it. Okay. Yeah. So I mixed the two together about 50-50.
What two?
Ultramarine blue and burnt umber. And I got to tell you what's going on with Cinnamon. So she's up there. They've got her own face on a box of brushes. They've made some custom brushes for her. You know, I'm certainly going to be excited to try them. And
that came up as a question from Brenda.
Yeah.
The question is Ginger going to start using Cinnamon's brush line?
Well, you know what? I certainly want to try them and see. I mean, I it's part of the company that supplies the ruby satin silvers, and I imagine there's some of those brushes in there that I like, and I certainly want to support my daughter in what she's doing. You know what I mean? I'm her biggest fan, you guys. You know, as her mom. You know. I know it's so funny. Years ago, I was on this camping trip, and there was this one woman, and when everybody introduced herself, she used to say, she said, I'm Hugo's mom. She apparently didn't have a name. She was just Hugo's mom, right? Okay? The whole weekend, she said, hi, you remember me, I'm Hugo's mom. Yeah, I'm thinking, okay, and we moms are kind of like that about our kids, aren't we?
You know what I mean? Charlotte's
look at
dad.
Look what my kid just did. She just, come on, you guys. She just got a huge brush representation, and you know, you got to figure what it cost them, that company, to tool up, you know, make those brushes, put that stuff. That was, they've invested in her, which I think is great.
Big time.
Big time. And I want to thank everybody that went out to their art supply stores and told people to carry her line of brushes, because it's already people have come up to the booth and talked about, getting a phone call saying, be sure to check out the Art Sherpa's brushes. So I just want to say that. Big shout out to Cinnamon on that. I think that's pretty exciting. There's this really nifty little tote bag. She sent me a picture. Ooh, so cute. So, I mean, it's great. And then she's got an ear to the, because I told her, I says, be sure to tell that lady that I want an angle brush that's this size, by the way, as long as you got the ear to the manufacturer.
Yeah. I don't know why they don't.
You know, I love the small one, and I want a big one. And who knows? You know, maybe after they recover the cost of all her brushes, they might consider just doing that.
Making one for you.
But I'm telling you what, that's the art guys are still going to carry her brushes, and still have
the art guys. I usually refer to them as the brush guys.
Sorry, the brush guys. You're right. The brush guys. There is.
Everybody's going to start looking around. No. Who's the art guys?
Well, there are the art guys. These are these guys in Houston. They're big art deal artists. The brush guys. Okay. And so we're just mixing some more paint here.
I have another question here from Jeanette. Did you pre-wet your brush before you started?
Did I? I don't think so, no.
We'd have to do a rewind. I don't think so. She usually doesn't.
No, I usually don't, because I don't want this thin. See, if you have the right brush, you know, I had someone write me today and say that they were having terrible time. Their paint was drying out too fast, faster than they could blend it. First thing my thought is that you're not using enough paint. And then this gal wanted to know if the paint perhaps was old. And she said, I guess she had some Liquitex that was pretty old. And she wanted to know if that would prevent it from, blending well. And I'm just going to tell you, I've got to show you this. Okay. So I'm designing a beautiful big painting in the middle of that
gorgeous.
For my Wave and Water Masterclass. And I was wandering around in the cupboard, you know, being an art hoarder, you know what I mean? I don't hoard a lot of stuff, but paint is one of the things I do. So I found this Utrecht acrylic paint. They actually did a full page ad of me some years ago in Artist Magazine and liked my artwork. And I had written them. I tried their paint and was very fond of it. And they had a store here in Houston, made it convenient to buy. It's called Utrecht. It's acrylic paint. They were one of the first makers of acrylic paint.
Can you slip it out underneath the camera?
This jar is, I got this back when Cinnamon got married. This is how old this jar of paint was. I went to use it the other day, and I got to tell you, it's perfect. It was perfect. It didn't have a seal or anything, and it was perfect. It hadn't dried out, right? It was perfect. So, I mean, that was 17 years old.
Is that paint still available?
Utrecht? I guess it's a
European?
No, it's made in New York State.
Well, why can't we get it?
Well,
we haven't tried.
We haven't tried because they don't sell it in stores. You got to order it directly from them, unless you're in one of their stores. And I haven't looked for them in a long time. But I was doing murals back then and lots of big paintings, and I bought a ton of it, and for this
really
one project. And I've got jars of it sitting around that I, So anyway, I wanted to use it. That's called neutral gray, by the way. That's a.
It looks like 18% gray to me from a photographer's point of
view. Well, maybe it is. It's neutral gray. It's almost the exact same color as this pad. Okay.
Yep.
All right. So now you see we've got this all covered. Now, see, that was pretty easy, wasn't it? See, like that. And that's what a brush does. That's when you have a good brush. It really puts the paint on, and that makes a difference. You can just spin around in circles with a soft brush, a brush that isn't great. I'm telling you what, brushes are everything.
Apparently, Dick Blick sells it, according to Wendy.
Oh, do they?
Yeah.
All right. You
trick me. We'll have to check it out.
As
a matter of fact, Blick owns them.
Oh, Blick owns them now? They bought them out?
Yeah.
You know, it was so funny. Back when they were featuring me on their ads for Artist Magazine, and they would send me paint sometimes, and then I would test it for them, too. And the president of the company said that he'd pay anybody $1 million that could teach him to paint. I said, you could fly me up there and give me a week and I could teach you to paint, you know, if you're serious about that. But it wasn't that serious, but, you know. So, I mean, that's interesting that, you know, he was head of this paint company. But
and he didn't think he can paint.
Well, I mean, I guess I could sell airplane parts and not think I could fly an airplane. I guess that's all right, but still. But we all know that, you know, it's possible now. You guys all know that you can teach that. All right, so let's dry this. Put the brush in water, and I'm going to dry this. John's going to show you some stuff while I dry it. If you are just tuning in before I do this, what we're painting today, in case you just joined us, is this little 8x10 painting. This is called
A Dark and Stormy Night.
It was a dark... And I'll tell you the story about that in a minute. I'm going to just go ahead and dry.
Okay, what we got tonight is... I'm not sure. Oh, here you go. How many paintings can a person paint in 7 days? They signed up for a 7-day membership. The record before that was 7. Currently, we have a new champion. Christine has done 15 paintings in her 7-day membership. Apparently she maximized her membership, people. So you can get a 7-day membership for how much? $9.95. How can you go wrong with that? Our good friend down in Australia, Sylvia, she created her own garden party. Apparently she combined a couple of different paintings together and came up with this. And Ginger's back.
Don't you love that idea? She put the bench together and the little settee set. The ice cream. I think people call that ice cream chairs. Isn't that cute? Because ice cream parlors used to have chairs like that outside their ice cream establishments. Those are called ice cream chairs.
I thought it was pretty clever.
I love it. Okay, so this is kind of dry. What we have to do is set a horizon line. And for those of you who are wondering, what is a horizon line?
Do you know what size Sylvia painting was?
Do what?
Do you know what size Sylvia's painting was?
I don't. I wish I did. But, you know, these numbers just come right in and out of my head. It's hard enough to remember the size mine are, you know, but I appreciate
it. Yes, I saw that on your recent video.
Ha, very fun. All right, yes. Well, all right, we're coming up here about...
3.5.
Thank you, John. 3.5 inches. I have my glasses on. I'm still trying to... You know, the funny thing about getting the cataract I was taken care of in the surgery is that... they don't do a thing for dyslexia, you know, just can see better, but you still have to translate what you're seeing, right?
John, right. What does the wave and water painting look like that she mentioned? Do you want to show a preview of it?
No.
Okay. You can't see it, sorry.
It's in process.
It is gorgeous, though. I tell you, it is a boat in a rough sea.
You know, an old-timey boat in a rough sea.
Old-timey boat in a rough sea.
Don't you like that word, old-timey? All right, we're going to use a triangle here. I should bring one of my smaller ones in, but here you go. When you have a triangle, all you do is line up one edge like this, and then you can draw the line. See, like this, and that's a straight line. Should be. Is it? Yeah, it is. Look at that. See? Straight line. I could measure here and measure there and all that, but I hate all that stuff, you know. Just one more thing to do. It's just that ghost calls right into the category of folding socks. One more thing to do that I just don't need to fool with. Okay. I was thinking about how many weeks of my life I have saved by not folding socks. And then, of course, I have only just white socks, so I just throw them all in a drawer and grab two.
And we won't talk about how you pick out your underwear, will we? You're the one that came up with the Braille underwear. First I've ever heard of it.
Well,
I looked on Amazon for it, and I couldn't find it.
Why you're even bringing this up at all? This is a G-rated
Somebody brought it up earlier. They
this
beat
is
me
a G-rated show. Then you know.
Well,
I'm
now
sorry.
We're going to PG. Uh-oh. Put the kids to bed.
Just okay.
Hey, Ginger, are you ever going to record the cockatoo that got messed up? This is from Azure Muse.
I don't know. I get inspired, and then I'm not. What can I tell you? Okay, so I'm going to take a chalk and just. I'm just going to do something like this. I'm just going to vaguely, this is my horizon line. I kind of want a hole down in here. I want something up here like this. Do-do-do. I want sort of a vague outline. And then I'm going to say I've got my cliff doing this. Okay, something like that. All right, there. That was easy. All right, and I've got a round brush, and it's pretty dry. It's a little too damp, and I'll tell you what, these are not as effective when they're damp. Let me just, because I used it before, so I'm just going to dry the brush real quick. Do you ever do that, just dry your brush?
Yeah, let's hold it up next to the microphone while you do that so we can make sure we hear it as you're doing it.
Well, yes, thank you.
Thanks
Good
for
tip.
Sharing that in my ears.
Sure, absolutely, love to do it. Okay, teach you the
easy. What is that?
This is a...
No, not that.
A number 8 Signet Robert Simmons round brush, okay?
Yeah, what's
that? And I don't know that you can, I don't know how much longer. You just need some sort of stiff 16, round 20. Brush. It doesn't have to be this brand, but use some sort of stiff round brush as opposed to a soft watercolor type brush, okay? All right, so we're going to come up here with the paint, and we're going to start with the transparent zinc white, or you can use mixing white, and just come on up here like this, and I'm using my brush, and I'm just going to suggest a little cloud up here like this. Maybe take a little of the background color and add to that. Ooh, that's a little blue. Let's darken a little brown here like this. A little more mixing white. There you go. So I've got this sort of, just suggesting almost like a little a nondescript cloud, and maybe come over here too. Making little circles and doing that. You've seen me do the cloud videos. We're not going to spend a lot of time on these clouds. I've got a bunch of cloud videos on YouTube on how to do these, but we're going to just suggest that this is some, kind of the first run of clouds. Then I want to take, I think I want burnt sienna. I didn't put a tab out for that, but I want a little tiny bit of that. That's a reddish brown color. I could have just, put a little bit of that with this, a little bit of zinc white. Zinc white or mixing white is very transparent. So when you're doing something like this, see, I'm just coming along here. It's pretty dark. Now I'm going to take a little more white, come right on top of that. Just add a little bit of light right there like that, okay? This is a good place to zoom in, I would say. John, this would be a good time to zoom in if you have a zoomy thing. Do you have a zoomy thing on this one? Okay, this is just a little bit of mixing white. What you want to make sure is that you are, your clouds are irregular. Okay, so here's a bit of the burnt umber and the burnt sienna. And I'm going to put that in there, maybe a little bit of mixing white with that. Just not too much. You don't want the sky too busy because we got a really busy ocean. So if you get the sky too busy, the whole painting becomes too busy. So we're just going to come down here with a little mixing white again. Just come along here and just create another little bit of clouds, maybe a little yellow oxide with it, tiny bit. Okay, and I'm going to come up here like this and suggest that I've got a pretty good cloud back here behind my... my lighthouse, which is going to go right here like that. Okay. See, I'm just making little circles and keeping moving. Then I'll get some more paint. Come along here. Here's another coat of hair. This is a little bit lighter here. And now you can use a brush like this. It works pretty good. I'll do my first layer of clouds with this because I just want something to kind of feel like mist and smoke and so forth. And here's a little yellow oxide, a little bit of burnt sienna. A little bit of mixing white like that, a little tiny bit of the brown. Okay, so here's this sort of maybe some more yellow, mixing white. There we go. I want to come into here like this and suggest, I don't know, some sort of light cloud back in here. And again, I just don't want to talk too much about this sky. Because really what you're doing is a story. You know, paintings are a story of some kind. They're a story. They're either, even abstract paintings. Someone wrote me the other day and said, I don't understand the purpose of abstract. Abstracts, you know, there's two different kinds of abstracts. There's the figurative abstract, where you can kind of see what it is, but they've, you know, maybe elongated it. Picasso was a guy that did that. He'd have one eye and a person and a weird nose somewhere, and you could kind of tell it was a person, but all his parts had been rearranged like Mr. Potato Head, that kind of thing, right? So... and then there's the, just the colors. But they still have to, this is important, they still have to follow a balance, big shapes, small shapes, medium shapes, light, dark, complementary colors. And actually, abstracts are a little harder to do because they really require a little bit of emotional input from the artist. Have you ever watched like American Idol or The Voice is on now? I love that show. And what they like to do is tell the person, it's nice that you can sing, but sing with emotion. And the guys that seem to do the best are ones that have had these giant tragedies in their life. And so when they sing these songs, they touch everybody. But it's, I think it's probably hard for someone that's had sort of a Pollyanna life to be able to get an emotion that perhaps they haven't experienced. And that's where, you know, some of these singers kind of went out. But with artists and so forth and abstracts, there's great emotion in them, can be. And those are the ones that really affect you, not just color and light, but the emotion in a painting is really something. All right, so now I'm going to come down here just with some mixing white. You see, I've been wiping off my brush. Come down here a little bit. I'm going to just suggest, this is suggest just a little cloud down here. And how about up here, too? I feel like something got lost up here, so we're going to break that shape up a bit. Something up here like that. All right, so there we go. So we got some clouds, and nothing too scary, just some clouds like that. Now, if I wanted to have a little bit more of an outline, okay, now I'm going into titanium white. Do you see this? Now if I come up here like that and pull it toward me like this, I can do maybe a little more of a white outline on this cloud like that. See, like this, and look where my hand is on the brush. And then just sort of smudge that out like this. This brush will do that too, or you can take like, I hate to use a good brush for this because you kind of mess them up. Let's see, what do I got that I can use that I'm willing to trash a little bit? Trashing. What am I willing to just sacrifice? There you go, that's the word I want, sacrifice.
We're looking for a volunteer.
I want a brush that I can just sort of scribble with.
What's that brownish color you have in the middle of your clouds?
What, here?
Yeah.
Oh, I think that was a burnt sienna.
Okay.
Okay. All right, we're going to use this one. It's a little big, but I can make this one work. Where is it? Here. All right, and the reason I'm willing to is I've sort of worn this brush out a little bit. It's a ruby satin silver, but it's worn out. All right? So now I'm going to take the dry brush. I'm going to take a little bit of the mixing white like that. Okay? Tap off some. And I'm not even in titanium, but I'm just using the corner of this brush. And you see what's happened is... Okay, now look, I can use it because the brush is stiff. I can get a little more definition on this, all right? Then I'll come back with a little brown and add a little shadow to this cloud on the bottom. Usually there's shadows. Did you guys think about that? There's shadows. Are you balancing the color now?
I'm going to balance the exposure. Apparently you're getting darker with all this dark.
Uh-huh. So didn't want to do that at the beginning. Says, oh, we're out of time. I can't do that at the beginning. Knew you'd want to do it. Balancing the color, but you know, colors are good to be balanced, John. I appreciate it. All right, so I'm going to take a little bit of the yellow oxide and a little bit of the burnt sienna. Here we go. Now look, I'm going to then a little bit more of the mixing white and come up here with this cloud like this. See, like this. Still in the mixing white. Now I'm going to wipe off the brush. What do you do with this? I'm still making the circles and then creating the clouds. See that? I'm still making the circles. Here's a little titanium. I think I want a smaller brush. I'm going to use a little angle brush. I want a smaller brush here because I can really get this in here with this. Because I can use just the point of the brush like this. Okay? Like that. There you go. If I want like a light edge to the cloud and then pull that down, the same thing right here. Pick a little bit of this light color. This is still into the the mixing white. And then see how I'm almost like shoveling snow. I'm pushing that up here like this, and then just coming on down like that. Bring that toward me like this. Then come back with this brush. Can't have enough brushes going when you're making clouds. Maybe I want a little bit of this burnt sienna raw umber combination like that. Like in here like this, and then put some little mixing white and maybe a little bit of dark brown over it. There we go. There, okay, something like that. That's nice. Then come back in here with some titanium. This is the next layer coming this way. And avoid kind of cloning shapes here. And I want something a little bit lighter next to this lighthouse. I'm going to come up here like this and do something like this. Lift up. Okay. Well, that's pretty. We're getting kind of a dramatic sky. You won't get the same sky twice each time. That's the fun thing. Every time you do this, you're going to get a different sky. So don't panic if your sky doesn't exist. You've seen a lot of skies in your life. So what you want to do is sort of rely on some of that memory that you've got of those. See, I'm coming in behind that with a darker color. See that? And I just have the light edge. And then just smudge that out. See how cool that is? And then maybe coming back under here with another one. You know, maybe a little, here's some titanium. Let's just come back under here like that. Wipe it off, add a little bit of dark. There we go, like this, something like this. And just push that up this way. Let's just change it a little bit. Well, it's fun to do skies. I could sit here and really talk to you and paint skies all day, really. Love skies. Absolutely love them. Because they change all the time, they're never the same. They're very relaxing to paint. Now when we come down here to the water, what I want you to do is turn it upside down. Because and let's see, take a bit of white, a little bit of the brown, a little bit of the gold here, and you've got to come back and forth. This is probably where a brush like this would be more helpful, because this is your water line here, and you want to make sure that it's that this is straight. If your horizon line when you're painting oceans is crooked, all your water fell off the planet somewhere. Remember how people used to think that the Earth was flat? Well, if you have your horizon line. Okay, so then what are we going to do with this one? I don't know. It's something different, right? Let's fix this one. Let's just come up here and fix that cloud. Okay, like that. Okay, that's fun. See, that's a good cloud. And come back up here and fix this one. Say that there's a cloud right here. There's some... See, and you'll see me wiping my brush off all the time. Like that. Put a little bit of burnt sienna in it. And I could spend a lot more time. I just didn't really want to spend all that much time doing clouds, but there's a lot of people that really want to know how to do clouds. And, you know, that's one of the more popular things to learn how to do. And so I'm not against, you know, doing it. Okay, let's just darken this up underneath it. Clouds always have a few little shadows. We need to come back under here and darken anything, like back into here. Maybe darken something in here like that. You can always come back with your darks. You know, if you got carried away, it's easy to do. Come back with your darks and kind of, I think we have to do something right here with the sky. Let me just darken this up right here. I'm not all that impressed with whatever happened here. Okay, Sarah, see, already that's better. Okay, so we've got a pretty decent sky going here. I feel like we need something right here. So maybe I'll just close this in. Here's another way. You can just take your brush like this and, let me just show you, kind of bend it towards you. You've got this angle brush and you can bend it towards you. See, and then let's just do that. You've got this neat little lip, you know. There we go, something like that. All right, that's nice.
Chris Che would like to know, should we try and keep the color, the clouds lighter that will be behind the lighthouse?
Yeah, see how I've got the clouds? The lighthouse is coming here. So if you don't get them lighter now, you'll have to come back and put them. That's all, right?
It's a lot easier to do it before.
It's a little bit easier to do it before, absolutely. It's a little bit easier before. But I would say we were pretty good. I mean, we could do a little bit of, you know, we could put a little bit more dark and balance this out a little bit on this side maybe with something. Just you know, maybe there's a little darker shadow here. You, if you have time and can just fool around with clouds, you can come back and layer them, you know what I mean? Like, see how I'm putting a little bit of paint right there and then just sort of shoving that in like this?
Mushing it around.
Mushing it around. Now, if you wet your brush, I'll show you, someone says, well, what happens if you wet it? If you wet it, it's a whole different animal. Now, it's going to blend differently, but you can wet it too. For instance, it's, you know, you can definitely wet it. And let's just push that up a little bit here so it's not quite so bright. Push that up that way. Okay. And I feel like something ought to come in here. I feel like we need something kind of coming loose into this spot like that. Maybe a background cloud that's sort of doing that, something to break that up. And this is too yellow here. That's bothering me. So let's come back and, let's see, right here, right there. Well, that didn't help, did it? Okay, let's take a little blue here. We got any blue? Yeah, we got a little blue here. Let's play with a little blue. There. From the, you know, ultramarine blue. Now, let's try a little mixing white with that.
Anne Marie's asking, Ginger, I think that a full moon would look good in the center. What do you think?
I had gone with that, a full moon in the center, and I had thought so too, but then I wasn't sure if it wouldn't distract from our lighthouse.
So then what becomes the subject, the clouds or the lighthouse?
The lighthouse. And the sky. You know, the idea is if there was a moon, and here's where I would put it. I thought about that because I did it actually in the first one. If I had a moon, maybe I would just put it right here like this, just barely suggest it with the little mixing white. Just suggest a moon right here without getting too nuts about it, right? Like that. You could suggest a little bit of a moon right there, and then you could put clouds, you know, so you've got something like that. You could suggest a moon with some little clouds going through it, right? But I'd put it really light. But, you know, again, these are the kinds of things with acrylics. You know what that's neat about acrylics. You try it. You don't like it. You do something else. Watercolor, it's a done deal. Oil, it's a done deal, pretty much. And I'm telling you what, I'm not liking. Just see how this line takes you right out of the canvas? See that? It just goes, whoops, bye. Can't have that. Kind of just soften that a little bit. Now, let's come back here and change this. There you go. Something like that. Just didn't need your eye going right out of the canvas at all. So let's put a little blue with that. Okay, so all right. So that when that dries, I'll lighten it up because then that got too dark. See that? Now your eye's going right there because that's too dark. But we'll lighten it up. But right now, in the meantime, let's get back to our
regularly scheduled program.
So we're going to come down here like this, and we're going to say that about three fingers here, we're going to do something like this.
Keith is saying that the horizon line looks higher on the left on the screen. Am I tipped or are you tipped?
Well, you know, it may be.
We have a ruler, right?
We have a ruler, and that's what rulers are for. See? So let's just see.
That's not a ruler.
We drew it. This is what this is for. We drew it eventually. So there it is.
That's square.
It's square. What's happened is he's seeing it. It is here. And this is going to be covered. Yeah. It is correct to the
the canvas.
It's correct to the canvas is here, but here he's right. But see, it's correct right here. This part's correct.
So you won't stress over it.
And then I'm gonna we're gonna go ahead and put our rocks in as long as we're doing that. Some sort of craggy rocks here.
What kind of rocks are they?
Craggy.
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 Craggy rocks.
As opposed to crabby. All right. And I think we're gonna do it at an angle here too. Let's put these rocks at a bit of an angle like that. Kind of coming up here, they're going to have these like this. All right, so there's some rocks. And then I started to draw this in, and you know we've got this is coming up this way. And then somewhere here we're going to break up this. Think of ocean waves as triangles. Okay? And then back out here there's another wave that's coming across. Oops. Maybe this isn't up this high. Okay? Okay, and then this one's coming across here. And then there's some stuff back here. That's pretty easy, right? All right, so then we start with the mixing white. Let's just come back over here underneath our horizon line. I think this part's straight. He was right about it. It went up that way. He was absolutely right, it did. And we appreciate that. Thank you. And now we're going to take a little bit of the angle brush like this, pinch it, a little bit of the titanium white, and just make these little thin lines here in the water. Now, don't put, the farther things are away, the smaller and less, distinct they are. So don't be doing waves clear in the back, okay? I mean, know what you're thinking. This moon ought to show up a little more here, like that. Okay, so maybe. All right, we're thinking about it. Okay, we're not saying you were wrong. You know, we're willing to try anything. You know, when somebody suggests it, we're just, you know, there we go. Okay, a little bit of moon, a little bit of clouds. Okay, all right. So now we're going to say that that's a little bit of this moon coming. Maybe some this moon's highlighting down here. Now I'm going to take the brush and I've got the white paint on it. You see here, I'm going to take it and then pushing it this way. Like that, and then I want to sweep some water down this way. Okay. All right. Now that's kind of a backwards way to do it, but this is as easy as any. Then you don't have to be so careful. Then you just come back here with a little brown paint, and you can just sort of add a few little shadows. And maybe you're going to say that there's the peak of this wave right here, like that, and this is more white here, like that. This is coming this way. Wipe your brush, then pull it kind of in a few little slivers that way. A little bit of shadow right here. This is why we keep all the same brown paint here, because there's shadows in the waves. If this were color, I think this would be harder for you to do, but you're not going to have any trouble with this because, and I say that because it's true, and because you can come back and skinny the lines. I get the biggest part I have is I can't do a thin line, but see how I'm just kind of...
Is that mixing white or titanium?
This is titanium, and I'm just doing that. And then I'll thin it up, okay? So I'm coming along here like this, and I'm going to say, this is titanium, coming about two fingers up from there, and then I'm going to pull this like this. Remember, water is falls straight down after it curves, right? There's a, this water is coming down over this part of the wave action, and then up in here like this, there's some wave action here. Like that. That's fun, right? And then up in here, we're going to give it another layer of water. Woo. Okay, and because this is still wet, it won't be so bright. Even though we're using titanium, it will not be as bright. Try to get some, always make sure when you're doing a waterfall, you can see some rocks through it, okay? Now our lighthouse is going there, and we'll put that in when it dries. In the meantime, let's take some mixing white and come back up here like this, using this angle brush, and let's sweep up some waves like this. So you just start here like this, and then let it go. And then some of this has got to be higher like this. It's got to be higher, and then you're going to come out like this. This is kind of almost what they call wind-whipped waves. Okay, wind-whipped. All right, and then I wanted to say that here's some titanium that I'm just kind of outline this wave with, and this is some white now, titanium white. It's coming up this way a little bit. It's a little bit brighter. See, it's a little stronger than the mixing white. And then I'm bringing this around in a curl. This is why I love these little angle brushes. All right, so here we got something like that, right? Cool, huh? Okay, so you're going, yeah, but my line's too fat. Well, it's okay. We don't care. Now, a little bit of mixing white here coming up this way. Sound effects. Like sound effects?
Gotta have sound effects.
Let's see. What are we going to do here? I give up. Let's go back and rinse the brush and come back with the plan.
Well, Cuds is asking, how is this a Cookie Crumbs lesson? It looks hard.
Well, you know, it really is kind of easy. I mean, I've just explained it to you. Because if you got to do the clouds. And then you come in here. Now look, I need a thin line. So look how I'm getting my thin line. I'm just coming back here with the dark paint and I'm painting in my line. So you don't have to know how to paint a thin line. Just paint an old fat one and then come up with a darker color underneath. And look at that. See how you can get a nice thin line, thick and thin line? All right, look at that. Isn't that cool? And then take a little bit of mixing white right in here like this. And just suggest, you know, a little wave action here like that. Okay, a little bit of brown here maybe. There, let's just bring a little bit of wave and mixing white, right, like around like this, see? A little bit of that burnt sienna like that, just suggest some color here. Now, here's the deal. Hold your brush like this and lift up. Spin it and lift up. There, okay? All right, gotta have a lot of action in something like this. Let's break up some of these little gems that we just put in here with some brown. Just break those up. Okay, that was easy. Now, let's see. Where I might keep moving my picture around. Okay. All right, now what I need is I'm coming back with our paint. This was our underpainting color. I'm going to come back with the dark paint, with a little bit of the blue, and I'm going to bring some, you know, brush strokes down this way, okay, because I know that I want this a little bit skinnier right here.
A couple of people have been asking if this is a stormy night, why is the back water so calm? Is it calm on the final?
Yeah. Because of the clouds. Because of the storm clouds.
Yeah.
What's the storm
class? It's just starting up.
But you're welcome to call it anything you like that makes it work
and
for you,
can,
right?
But you can even make it more rough seas in the back.
But if you get it too busy, you know, you want to be careful. You know, some people might want to, you know, put a little, we've got some wave action coming up here like this, and I need to make this wave a little bigger here. We've got some wave action coming this way on this wave like that. Let's just pull it that way. There's our wave action here. See? And then this is pretty dark right up here, under here like this. Okay, so you've got this wave back here doing it, and we haven't put in any of our shadows in this wave. See, there's shadows in this wave. That's the key thing. There's these shadows in the waves. Now, if this were a painting that was in color, you might not think to put the shadows in, but if you do it like this, it may occur to you to put the shadows in, you know, in a painting that with that you've got more color in. Here, there, a little bit of white here. Let's just bring that up here like this. Tilt that down here like this. Off it goes. There we go. All right, so there's our waves. Now, I think this is dry enough up here where we can put in our lighthouse. Okay?
Spar is asking, say someone wanted to add a rain to this painting. How would you do that?
Add a what?
Add rain.
Well, the thing of it is we've got the lighthouse with the lights. So you'd start really screwing it up then. You get it too busy, and then you've just got a hot mess. So, you know what I mean? You got to decide. Do you want the lights from the lighthouse, or do you want rain? And then you'd have something similar to this coming down from the, you know, in certain sections of the clouds. You know how the clouds will rain in certain areas?
Yeah.
But you can't. I wouldn't do both. Okay? You got to pick what you're talking about. Okay? So, all right. So right about here, we're going to come on up here. A lighthouse is taper. They're not...
straight up and down.
They're not straight up and down. They're kind of they have a taper to them. Then there's always a window area, and then they have like a little tiny triangle for the top hat. I mean, they're just kind of, they made them all the same. Mostly they made them the same. If you do that, and then we're going to say this is in there, it's built into the cliff here. So we're not getting too clever with this. We're just keeping this real simple, okay? And let's see what we got here. Oh, ta-da-ta. How big is this? Trying to rule it the right way. The whole thing was about 3.5 inches tall. And how did I do with this? About right. Okay, so that's about what I made this. Okay, let me move this brush out of the way into the water. Where did we put the angle brush? We just had it. Huh. Didn't we just have it?
You had it earlier. You showed it to us.
Well, I've been painting with it for the last second. Or two. Or three. Where did we do with it? Well, remind me to find it again before we close tonight so the paint doesn't dry in it. All right, so here's our picture, okay? Here's our picture. There's our lighthouse. So let's just take some burnt umber and ultramarine blue, and here's our angle brush, and we're just going to paint that in. You don't want any white on the brush. Now, I would recommend really drying this. I'm not going to, but I would recommend drying it all the same. I'm going to turn this sideways. For me, the easiest thing is to turn it sideways because we're going to have to paint over this chalk. And then I'll bring the paint toward me. All right, like that. There we go. Paint that sideways. And I'll do the same thing. This is where you might tape the lines. This would be very effective if you took a moment and taped these lines. Again, your paint has to be very dry to do that, but this would not. Those of you who have watched other lighthouse videos that we've got, do you have one of those on the wall, John, we have on our lessons for lighthouses? Because we've got a good one on our Academy website. Good, really good lighthouse.
Oh, look at that. Once you flip it back around so I can make sure I'm lined up.
All right, so now Now, what I did was I went ahead and just painted out the part where the light is, okay, where the actual light's going. And I did that because it was just it's easier to dry this and then I'm going to bring my rock out a little bit more here, too, now. I've done that, see? It was easier to dry this way. Where on earth did that other little brush go that I had? I do not understand where it went. Okay, here's... All right, let's try one more time. Here's another brush, another angle. All right, so now... All right, so we've got that. We've done this. And then up here... I've got a little tiny, this is just a little tiny triangle. The chalk is a bit of a challenge to paint over. I'll tell you what, I prefer, and I don't happen to have any sitting around, but I have prefer, there's a white charcoal pencil by General. You can get them on Amazon. I think we even have a link to them on our website. I prefer drawing in with that because it's much easier to paint over than this. Okay. So, all right, so there's this this little lighthouse cap thing here, like this. Okay, like there you go. Let's make this a little darker. There you go. There you go. All right, so there's our lighthouse. Now, at this point, this is not a bad plan to dry this, all right? This is when you would go ahead and dry this. See if I can do anything before I dry it. I know I want a little bit of a light line under here, like this. Pinch the brush. This is titanium white. Okay. What's that?
You have the Ecuador painting?
I had the Ecuador painting. And you're just going to pull this down like this. Where is my brush that I had? Okay. So you see where we've got the light now. All right, so John, I have to dry this before I get much further, but oh, I gotta show you this. This is, John says, where's the Ecuador painting? Let me show you, we have another lighthouse besides this too. This is one, we have several lighthouses. Here's another lighthouse we've got. This is a palette knife painting we have on. Is this a part of the Wave and Water Masterclass?
Yes.
This is the Wave and Water Masterclass, and this is, see how the rocks are done with the palette knife? We've got this little, we've got, this was almost a about 98% palette knife painting.
Yeah.
Okay, but we taped the lighthouse. All right, isn't that cool? That's what part of our Wave and Water Masterclass series. Then we've got that one in the globe. That was a lighthouse. That was another good one that's on the wall. All right, so you see our light. You see our lighthouse. You've seen all this. Now, let's just take a second and dry this. I'm just going to show you Ecuador. Every week, our members get. Remember, gingercooklive.gallery. We have a weekly release. Last week we did the old English truck, which was our members are doing. Some people are doing. I mean, I know I do more paintings than any of you guys could possibly keep up with, but not everybody wants to paint trucks. Guess what? But wait till you see this. Check this out. Is this gorgeous or what? This is called Ecuador, and it was originally painted in 1810. And we'll tell you all about the artist that originally did it. And it was painted in Ecuador. How cool is that? Look at the funny little birds up here. Is that neat? I thought, you know who I thought would love this would be our Andrew, our friend that lives, our artist friend that lives in Haiti. I bet if he painted this large, this would look absolutely cool, right?
Stunning, as it were.
Stunning. All right. So anyway, there's Ecuador. Got to show you guys that. Had a brag on that. Everybody asks us what we do. I mean, what do you do with your days, you guys? I create. I mean, I'm creating lessons all the time. I create. I'm kind of letting that dry a second. Today, while I was creating this, I also did this one. This is another. These are called two cherries, and this is going to be for in our members gallery. It'll go with the apple painting. It's 8x10. I don't know if we have the apple painting handy, but that's going to be it. Somebody asked about that, and that'll be a two cookie lesson.
It'll probably go with the apple, the tangerine.
The apple, the tangerine. It goes with that whole series of kitchen art. Isn't that pretty? So there, we did that. So that's kind of stuff we do. I'm going to go ahead and dry.
Wait, before this. You want to do the art critique of Sherelle?
Oh, sure. Yeah, let's do that because, you know, one of the benefits of being a member, besides having all those paintings to do, is that you get art help. And I got to say that Cyril was, She knocked it out of the park with this painting. This was the original painting she sent me for help with, okay? This is one of the benefits, that you can send it as you're painting it, and I'll make suggestions, okay? So she sent that, and then I said, you know, it really was excellent, but her coffee cup, you see, needed to be more oval, and she needed more of a jagged line, and she needed some definition on her beans, and she needed to break the beans up a little bit in the bag, and also, you know, on the top of the grinder, all right? Now, check out her finished piece that she sent me today. Is that not gorgeous or what? Isn't that beautiful? I just was so impressed with that, okay? So, anyway, that's one of the benefits of having a personal art coach, is sometimes one or two suggestions. Sometimes it's just one small thing. By the way, if you did this, it would really help. You know, somebody sent me one of those recently, and they had it all drawn out, and I suggested they straighten up the handle a little bit. That was all. Everything was great, except the handle was a little off. Just never know. So anyway, great job, Cyril, and thanks for letting us share your artwork with everybody.
Before you draw, can you show the cherries one more time? And yes, the tangerines that we did in the
Do you have the tangerines? Do you have them you can show?
The chess.
All right, we've got this series of paintings and lessons that we're going to be doing. Here's the cherries. This will be on our site. And then the apple and the cherries. Everything should be right there. The tangerines, the cherries, here's the tangerines. All right, and that will also be a lesson on our gingercooklive.gallery coming up. Probably, I think March is full, but probably in April, we'll probably have this one. And then look how cool that these look together. And then here's the apple. See? Here's our apple. So these are all, this is all part of this grouping. What we try and do is do a grouping so that when you paint, you've got a nice series of paintings either to sell. And listen, you're more than welcome to sell these too. You know what I mean? When you paint them and sell them, yes, sell them. If you do a few, if you do enough of these, I think what'll happen is that it will come to you to, maybe make up one of your own. You know what I mean? You'll get the idea of how to paint it, and then you'll have to tell us what you did, you know, because I'm always interested. You're going to spring off. You know, I can teach you technique, but I can't teach you a good idea. Some of you guys have really good ideas, better than I have. I'm just going to show you the technique. Okay, I'm going to dry this real quick. I think it's almost dry, but just let me blast it for about 2 seconds.
Go.
You ready?
Yep. Well, that's a very long 2 seconds, if you ask me.
Were you making comments about how many seconds?
No, not me. I didn't say a word.
I
didn't say a word.
Oh,
just
you did.
Sitting
you
here.
Did. Mm-hmm. You were never just sitting there. Okay, let's just talk about that. The blackboard's coming out, right? All right, I got a lighthouse. Let's turn it this way, okay? Want everybody to be on page with this. Here's on point with this. No fun. Here's my lighthouse, okay? Round at the bottom, okay? But then we've got some rocks that are coming through here, so you don't really see that. And then you've got this little bit right here. That's where the light is, okay? And then you've got your little sort of triangle that's coming up like that, right? And then sometimes there's a little knob on it. Okay, now here's what you do. If you put the line straight across, it will not look round because we can't really do any shading at night, very much shading. So what you have to do is like the rope, you've got to curve these lines like that, okay? You've got to curve them, and that will suggest, and even this can be curved a little bit, you've got to suggest a curve on the white lines, okay, like this, on the white stripes, okay? So, and then we'll the light's kind of coming from this direction, so we'll make these darker over here on this side, and this will be lighter on this side, okay? This will be our light side, all right? Then we'll have some light in the lighthouse. Obviously, we've got to put some light in here, okay?
Now, when you come to this point, Gail was saying that the light from a lighthouse does not shoot down as strong of an angle you have. And she is an expert on lighthouses because she has over 50 in her collection.
Really? It doesn't shoot as far down?
It doesn't shoot down. No, it shoots out because you're giving a warning to the people further out.
Okay, so she's saying that I took a little license, like the liberty with that. But anyway, so now you're going, it's coming out this way. Like she says, it shoots further out. But I mean, it tapers out.
It's
narrower
straight.
And gets wider. Does that make sense? The rays?
Probably what you have is you're going to have a soft spill in the bottom and stronger further out.
Yeah, probably so. But that's okay. A good point. We always appreciate that, you know. So anyway, but that's your shape, okay? So that's what you're drawing. So now that you know that, that was good to know, right? Because, I mean, it's very hard to paint things you're not sure what is. Then we're going to just suggest a little curve here on our lighthouse.
And these are your new pastel chalks, right?
New pastel chalks. But I tell you what, I like that general charcoal pencil much better. Well, actually, Conte makes a white... I could never figure out how to sharpen them.
Like this one I keep sharpening for you. Where are you keeping it?
I don't know. It just gets dull and then I don't use it. But I like the Conte too because, again, it's sometimes a little hard to paint over chalks. All right, so there's my stuff. I'm going to take a little bit of mixing white now and just put my, well, let's do titanium, tiny bit of yellow oxide and a little bit of brown with that. How's that? Kind of gray that out there. All right, so we're going to say this is our stripe because it's nighttime, so we don't want it too light. Then we're going to put it here too, like that. I don't think you need a lot of these. We're just going to say that they're doing that. Then I want to take a little bit of the yellow oxide. This is where and just come up here like that into the lighthouse, like that. Just a little tiny bit of that. Then I'll take a little bit of white. I'm going to turn it sideways, okay? Because I'm saying the light's coming from this way, so then I'm going to bring it. Just with my angle brush. I love these little angle brushes for that reason. I'll pull that this way and suggest that it's round because we've kind of done a shadow. Now you don't want a stripe, okay? So then pinch your brush and sort of just fuzz out the middle part so that it's gradations around, okay? So there's your lighthouse. Here's our, let's see, this is where I wanted the CAD red medium. Just a teeny bit of that, just very little. I'll move the sticker. It'll bother John if the sticker's not where the paint is. And maybe a little bit with the CAD yellow. Just make a little bit of orange in here like this. Just a touch there. Then we'll come back up here with the dark color. And we'll come around here like this. And then using just our angle brush, we'll put some up and down lines in it like this. Like that. There you go. So there's our lighthouse. There you go. And I'm going to even up my stripes a bit. Okay. There we go. All right. We've evened those up and kind of get rid of the chalk line too. Like that. There we go. And now I'm going to take some white, you know, some water. And well, it's not water. I'm going to apply water by coming down here like this in this direction. It's suggesting that there's some water running off this cliff like that. Okay, just a little mixing white. Then back with a little titanium here like this. All right. Okay, there we go. All right, so that's what we've got there. Now I feel like I've got to take some white here and put a little line under here like this. And under here like that.
We're working on an 8x10 canvas for those that are just joining us.
Yeah, a little 8x10 canvas. We're just playing around here, just having a good time making clouds and stuff. And let's just come up here like this. And let me make this cloud a little darker right here next to this. Now I'm just going to got that a little wide on my... There, look here. I'm just going to... There, see? I mean, you can touch up some lines. You know, if it gets a little out of control here... You know, you can touch up a few little lines with the clouds or something, right? There you go. So that's our lighthouse. Okay. So here's what we've got so far. Zoom back out for me, would you? All right. So that's what we've got so far. Okay. So now you can see I've got some. I'm looking at what I've got with my clouds. I haven't put my light in. Now I'm just playing around. Now I'm just going to start touching up things, as far as. You know, maybe taking some titanium white and doing this. And now I'm going to take my brush and lift it up. Let's see. Let's use some mixing white for that.
Go ahead and stack them again, and then I'll get the palette with it.
Like this? Yeah. I'm going to just take some mixing white and bring it up on the cliff like that. So that's it's splashing up there. Now, you could use a toothbrush on this and, you know, do that too. That would be okay to do a little bit of a line like that. You absolutely could. Now that I've got my clouds here, I'm not going to come here like this and maybe do this with the clouds. This has had a chance to dry pretty well. So here's a little bit of clouds in here. I want a little bit of a lighter, you know, cloud right there. I'm looking at that. Okay, so what else can I do? I'm just seeing where else can I be with this. We could probably take some titanium white now and just come on up here into our big wave a couple of places and add some accent color. And that's what I'm kind of doing now here, is I'm just a little bit of light here. Here's this one, and I really like this wave that's coming across here like this. It's coming across like that, maybe. And then somebody suggested that perhaps it was a little rougher, but if you get it too rough back here, here's the problem with that. You get it too busy. That's why I just sort of kept it. You know, this, you know, I've called it, you know, stormy, you know, sky because, you know, it's this clouds, but maybe it just rained and now it stopped. I don't know. Stormy sea. And then, you know, with oceans, that storm doesn't necessarily start here. It starts like in China and rolls up. You know what I mean? You could have a perfectly calm sky and have a wildly stormy sea because the waves came somewhere else, okay? Waves came way somewhere else. So all right, so let's come behind this one now a little bit and play this. Any other questions while we're happily doing this?
Yes, Anne Marie just asked, could I use watercolor pencils to outline instead of chalk?
Yep.
Yes.
You bet. I don't own any, but you sure could.
I do.
You do? You never said. Listen, he's been holding out on us. He owns watercolor pencils. Where was this information?
Well, I used to do the watercolor stuff.
Well, yeah, I know, but did you bring all that stuff with you?
Yeah, think so.
That's in those boxes you haven't unpacked?
Right.
Okay. All right.
I've only been here a month.
This is the guy that folds the socks, but he's still, you know, hasn't unpacked everything yet, so he's still thinking about it, right?
You don't want to jump into anything.
I can see that, right? Just in case you want to just get in your car and go home back to Michigan, right? You're keeping your options open. He's not unpacking anything. I'll know he's staying when he unpacks his boxes, okay? Though John and I have talked about moving out of Texas. We have discussed that. A little bit, and then we're here for a while, but not for a while. We've talked about that, though. All right. Something. I love these clouds. Don't you guys love these clouds? Aren't they pretty? Let's just... play with the moon here, because we did that. Yeah, there you go. That's fun, too, this moon business. I don't know, I kind of like the moon in this one. You don't have to put it if you don't like it, but I think it was a pretty good suggestion. We've got the moon peeking through. We've got these clouds. I don't know, I think I had paint on my wrist when I did that.
Yeah, I was wondering where those two dots came from. Is that somebody looking through the...
the little eyes going.
Little eyes looking
Hello,
at
it. Who's there? Right? And let's just put a little.
I'm bad. Anne Marie sorts her socks by colors and packs them in Ziploc bags.
Really?
There you go.
Well, she has more than one pair then, I bet.
She has more than white, apparently.
More than white, right? Wow, that's impressive. I don't know. I want to do something right here with this. Just pull this around, too, and I just...
We're getting suggestions on where to go.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, we have Arizona, North Carolina, winter in Texas, summer in New England.
Isn't it pretty hot in New England? I mean, no offense, but isn't it pretty hot there? I mean, I thought that you guys had the heat just like everybody. I've looked at the weather map, I'm thinking, well, if I could live anywhere, where else would I go, right?
Well, and, there's no place perfect. I've been here for 6 months already. I can't even believe that. We just calculated that the other day. September 1st. Not Illinois. Florida's nice. Okay. John, you guys are going to live on the high seas. That's from Lori. That is our goal.
Yeah, okay. So, all right. So, I've got my clouds now. I kind of like those, and we're not going to get too much carried away with that. But there you go. There's our clouds. There's our ocean back here like that. There you go. So now let's try it one more time, and then I will put in the light rays from our lighthouse, which I think would be very pretty, right? Those little eyes are still showing up. Man, whoever's living in this. That's fun. You know, it'd be funny just to, it's perfectly great painting, and then you've got these little eyes sticking out. You know what I mean? This is,
yeah, I wonder where they're coming from.
You know, or police tape by around the lighthouse, or, you know, that kind of thing, right? Here, let's just do that like that. So we just cover that lighthouse up like that. And, okay, I can see that.
We have somebody suggesting Alberta, Canada.
Well, we talked about that. Here's the thing. We Dutch, you Canadians, you've got to help us out. We thought about Canada. We really did, because we just thought that would particularly would be interesting. But if you want to live in Canada, they just don't open the doors and say, give us your tired, your poor, or whatever that deal is. You know, they have these rules about who can come. And I think there's an age limit of who can immigrate. I mean, I could be wrong, you know, but I think there's an age limit of who they let in. Let's see, I wanted to break this up a bit too, here, like this. There we go. Okay, and then we're just breaking this up like this. Okay, all right, I'll dry, and we'll talk, and I'll dry.
Okay.
Yeah.
Drying. Well, what do I have for you folks? Do I have anything else to show? I don't think I do. Nope, not tonight. That's all we've got tonight. A couple of you noticed on the website, we used to have a list that would show all of our lessons. That is no longer working because the list got too big. So we're having to rebuild our galleries, and that's going to take some time to get done. The search engine... Why did that kick in noisier to me? The search engine is working quite well, though. If you have something you can look for, if you have any troubles, though, do feel free to contact us and let us know which lesson you're looking for. Canada will be expensive tax-wise if you are American, no age. They will be glad to take your money.
Do you think so? I thought because we got, I thought after a certain age, they just didn't want us to, they say, oh, we don't want any of these older Americans from, coming up with the health, you know, because
the health,
health insurance issue.
Yeah.
That's what kind of thought. Oh, you guys, I want to just mention before I put the light thing in here, if you haven't seen our new painting,
let me zoom out.
Our wishing well. And, just to look for the video on this. It kind of explains it. But this is what we launched that last.
Yesterday. Yesterday on YouTube is a rental.
It's a rental.
It's not in the members area. It's not a downloadable. It's a rental. It's what we're using to help fund our scholarship plans. And it's $2.99. Currently, you cannot watch it on an iPad, an iPhone, or an Android device.
Oh, I'm telling you what. This was the hardest thing we ever tried to do, is put this silly thing up on YouTube for a rental. That, you know, we thought, well, that'd be good. A lot of people would see it. If you're one of those countries, they gave us a list of countries that we could pick from to
do. And you have to list them each individually.
And then we had to come back and figure out what their money was, the rubies or whatever, ruples or whatever, for each country, and then we had to do the exchange rate and put it in. So we had to figure out with $2.99 that with all these countries, and then like Japan wasn't even listed in their group. And so I mean, this is so crazy. We're gonna eventually get this up, hopefully this week, on Vimeo too. And here's why: because Vimeo, you just put it up there. They handle all that. They take apparently everybody's money.
They don't care.
They don't care.
And they work on the iOS devices and the Androids.
Yeah.
You would rent it. It's rented for 72 hours. If you rent it, you have 30 days in which to start your 72 hours. But once you've started your 72 hours, it ends. So if you started on Tuesday at 2, it ends on Friday at 2.
This was not us. This was, we had two choices, 72 hours or 24 hours.
48 hours. 48 or 24. 48 or 72, that's it.
48 or 72.
Yep.
That was our choices. And so we made it to $2.99 in case you had to rent it again. Okay, because that normal rentals for us on Vimeo, when we do a rental, they're anywhere from $6 to $8-$10 a rental. So we thought this was, so we try to make it, that's how we did it. We got, and oh my gosh, it was hard to do. So, maybe the one and only time we ever do it on YouTube, but we hope you guys love it. I think it's really cool, and we're sorry that the iPads and the iPhones don't work. I tell you what, though, I didn't know it. You can rent all kinds of movies on YouTube.
Yeah.
But not on your phone your tablet.
Yeah,
I mean, I'm talking about full-feature, full-length
new releases.
Hollywood movies. We were on Amazon, John and I, and we watched some movie that Meryl Streep was in. I think we rented it and I'm a Prime member, for like $5, $5 or $6, and it was $0.99 on YouTube
for
one day or something. But again, you couldn't watch it on your phone. Right. Anyway, just a piece of trivia. But even I was talking to Cinnamon Day. She had no idea either. So I probably would use them to watch feature films. All right.
At least check our pricing.
At least to check their pricing against Amazon. All right. So I'm going to... no, we're going to put the white in first. Let's change brushes. Let's get a wider brush.
You have quite a selection of brushes this evening.
I do. They're all over here. What is this one? This is glasses. 1/2 inch. All right. That's pretty good. You want to take your mixing white and just kind of spread it out like that. Kind of flatten it out on your brush. Kind of make a point of where you're going to start. You know what I mean? That kind of figure that out, right? Then you're going to start like this. And then as you go flatter, okay, like this, kind of get thin and then widen it out here like this. Like that. So there it is, right here, like that. There's the light coming there, like that. Isn't that cool? Then we'll do another one. I'll have to defer to the gal that knows lighthouses because, you know, I'm just doing this as an artist.
Paint yours as you like it.
So paint yours any way you like it. But I'm just saying that this is the, you know, here's our light.
Yes, the wishing well is a rental only.
Yeah. And it is to help our scholarship fund on our channel. Now, I personally, I know that technically is probably true the way it is, but I'm adding another one right here just for balance. And then, you know, like that, just put one down here like that. There you go. That's your transparent white, okay? See how cool that is? Isn't that just absolutely neat? Okay, and then you can use that same white to come up here like this if you need to have, you know, suggest more splash when you want it a little bit more wispy, you know what I mean? Like, and bring that around like that.
Like, oh, somebody's saying something about one of the waves. Let me see if I find. Is the water on the rock coming down straight or curved?
Well, it curves over the rock and then comes straight down. Then it goes straight down. See how it's curving here? It comes like this and curves and then goes straight down.
Thank you very much about the comments about the poem. We did put our heart and soul in it and spent quite a long time coming up with that one.
Yeah, we did. Yeah, we did. That was really fun. So that's our way. You know, here's our... And then, if you get too carried away with your rocks, just come, you know, with your water, just come back and add a few. Put some rock back. You know, don't get this solid, okay? And try not to get it too even either. That's a good thing, too. Just try not to make it like a fence. If you find yourself doing that, that's an easy enough thing to correct. You see me all the time pinching my brush like this.
Wait a minute.
Then it come around like this and...
Have you had a recipient yet from the scholarship fund? Yes, we've had several.
Oh, yeah. In fact, we've been doing scholarship funds for 2-3 years. We
basically
do this all the time.
Opened the door, we put that in.
You know, as soon as we opened the door, we put the Karen Little, which is on John's wife of 40 years, passed away a few years ago. The first thing we did when we set up the new company, which was Ginger Cook Live on, you know, Academy of Fine Art, was we started scholarship funds. We started that and just put our own, you know, savings into it and scholarship people to, weren't able for a number of reasons. Goodness, we've got a gal that we sponsor from Greece. Apparently they're not allowed to take their money out of the country. It's not a matter that she can't afford the lessons. She just can't, she illegally cannot, she's not allowed to pay for them.
Yeah, no money can leave Greece. Go figure that one out.
These are called wind whips when you do this on the water like that, a little bit of wave, like that little wave action there. A little bit of wave action, a little bit of wind, just curve this a little more like that. These are called wind whips. I really don't like this point here. Excuse me while we paint it out. Yeah, no, I thought that was, I really don't like that one. There you go. Let's just curve this around like that. Sorry. That was really bugging me. Oh, couldn't stand that at all. Here we go. Now let's see what I can make something work with here. Like that. Yeah, no, we've got kids. You know, kids in high school that, you know, I mean, that, you know, their parents aren't able to, you know, get the lessons. They barely pay for the paint. We've got disabled people, one lady. And some of you, I want to thank you guys that have been sponsoring, you know, this because you've helped a lot of people. And sometimes they want to, you know, you're happy to know who your who you're helping, and what we, you know, we put some couple people in touch with their, with the person they're helping, and they've found new friendships. So it's very nice.
We have one lady that's I was writing to talk about the lady in Germany that's deaf.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now she was going to try to, you know what I mean, and I want to say something because we don't close caption anything. I think there's a button on YouTube if you're
under an hour.
If you're under an hour, you can do it, but they never. My phone doesn't know what I say. I mean, I don't dare just speak into the phone and send the message. I could be telling you anything, you know. So we don't have that so much, but anyway, I think that would be, you know, it's a very nice thing, and we think that's very much. And also, we want to thank everybody for their suggestions on the fun things we've been painting. I've gotten some really good suggestions lately on stuff, and I want to thank you for that. That's really good. And I would say we're pretty close to done here, John. I think that this, you get the idea of how you'd paint something like this.
I do.
You know, kind of a stormy sky, and I got to tell you how this... This was a story we used to get at camp. I don't know if you guys ever went to summer camp when you were a kid, but that was the thing when I was a kid. And the counselor, we'd go out sleeping in the woods, and they'd say, tell us a ghost story. And it was.
We always start off.
So the captain said to the mate, tell us a story. And the mate began. It was a dark, stormy night. And the captain said to the mate,
tell us a scary story.
And the mate began. It was a dark, stormy night, and the captain said to the mate,
tell us a scary story.
And the mate began. Anyway, that's the dark, stormy night ghost story.
Ginger, where do you buy your brushes? TheBrushGuys.com.
BrushGuys.com, www.TheBrushGuys.com, and you go to teacher page and look for my name, Ginger Cook, and you will see a list of the different ruby satin silvers. My two favorites, if you're just going to get a couple, there's are the short-handled angle brushes. One is a 3/4 inch, and the other is 3/8 inch, and maybe a 1/2 inch. 3/8.
3/8 quarter.
3/8. Sorry, 3/8, 1/4, and 1/2 inch.
You look in the Wishing Well description, you will find the link in there, and all her recommended stuff.
Yeah, there you go.
In the Wishing Well.
I want to just put a few more shadows in this, like that.
Hey, we'd like to thank everybody for joining us this evening. We had 325 total visitors at one time.
Oh, my gosh, that's so nice. Thank you so much, you guys.
But only 188 thumbs up. No thumbs down, though. We'll take that.
We'll take that very much. We thank you. And I'm telling you what, you could fool around with this for a while. You just don't want to get it too crazy. But you see how I'm even now, after it's dry with a little mixing white, even now I can come back and add a few more clouds. Look, you got to do the sound effects. Look at that. See, I'm just adding a few more clouds in there. I'm telling you, the way to paint clouds is to put on classical music and paint away.
And just go with the flow.
Go with the flow, you guys. But all right, so this is a neat picture pattern. I think this is really fun, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thanks. And tomorrow night, I don't know what we're going to paint, but we'll paint something.
Joanne, thank you much for the donation of $5. We appreciate that.
Oh, thank you, Joanne. That was lovely. Thank you very much. We appreciate it, you guys. We just really do, and hope you're enjoying this. And don't forget to sand your canvas. And the other thing, the happy word is spray the back of it. In fact, you should do that before you start with water. Spray the back.
But, hey, we'll do it after.
It after. It doesn't matter, but it's just kind of tighten that up. Tighten that up. Spray the back of it. It'll make it easier to paint on. And I think you can, I don't think you're going to have any trouble frame. I have great confidence in you. You're going to have no trouble painting this. This will be easy peasy.
Easy peasy.
Easy peasy.
Easy peasy. Hey, we'll be back tomorrow night, won't we?
Yeah, back tomorrow night. Same time, same channel.
Same bat channel. Same bat time, 7:30 Central Time. Good night, Ginger.
Good night, John. Good night, Sammy.
Good night, Sammy, who is snoozing today.
Good night, you guys. Good night.